Jeff Charles with us, the voice of the Pirates. We talk all things Pirates here live in the studio this Tuesday morning. Jeff, welcome.
Welcome.
All right, so first two games of the season, we were all steam ahead. We were doing good, and then we had a little sputter. What happened to the offense?
Well, too many mistakes, Dante. Yeah. That was a problem. The Pirates turned the ball over four times the ball over three times inside the five. And,
right.
You know, I talk with coaches, players, media, fans. I can't remember a game like that, and no one else can either.
Right.
And so it was frustrating.
No. You don't want to.
No,
it was frustrating. The defense pretty much held up there into the bargain, though. What did they do right?
Well, defense just played great. I mean, they got hit early, you know, with that kind of blitz. And then with about 7 minutes to go in the first quarter on throughout the rest of the game, they played well. Well, they stuffed the run pretty well.
Right.
They did a good job against the passing attack also of South Carolina. Uh-huh. So the guys played well. Dimitri McGill, the nose guard up front, played great. Uh-huh. Corey Sargent in the back end of the defense played terrific. So the Pirates did a good job defensively.
So do you think the noise level, the atmosphere of the Gamecocks played a role in maybe the loss we got?
Well, I don't know about that. I think you overcome that. I think after one or two series, then everything tends to settle down, and then it's just another football game.
Exactly.
But I'll tell you what hurt and set the tone for the game was the big kickoff return to start the game.
Right.
And then you gave them a short field. They punched it in, and before you could blink, it was already 7-0.
Exactly.
So that really set the tone for the game, and that was tough.
All right, the Hokies, they're a pretty good team. Let's just be honest. What do we got to do? What do we learn from last week? What do we got to do to prepare for the Hokies?
Well, you got to be physical. Anytime you play Virginia Tech, you have to bring your hard hat because
Trust me, Ohio State Buckeyes know.
Yes, exactly. You know all about that because they're very, very physical teams. So you've got to match that intensity in both your offensive and your defensive line. Mm-hmm. And then the Pirates are going to have to do a good job against the running game. They've always made their running living running the football.
Right,
but also, now with their new coach, they throw the ball a lot better than what they have, too. So
That's
they've
good.
Got a junior college quarterback, Gerard Evans, who's a real talent.
Right,
Pirates are going to have to defend him. And then on the offensive side of the ball, Pirates are going to have that diversified attack again against a real good defense.
And that's what it's all about, the versatility there. You got to keep up with that. All right, Jeff Charles, doing it big here in the studio live on a Tuesday morning. Jeff, thank you very much.
Thank you,
Dante. We'll see you next Tuesday.
Sounds
about
great.
The win that we'll get against the
Hawks. Yeah, let's hope so.
All right.